Hello guys and welcome back to Vivi with Rafiq. So today we will be going to check out the Revolt's RV400. We will be going to see what are the pros and cons of this vehicle. So let's get this video started. So the RV400 comes with a 3 kW motor which is placed over here. It's a belt driven motor. To power it, it uses 3.25 kWh battery pack, a lithium battery pack unit which is placed over here. Then next, it comes with a dual disc for the front and the rear. It comes with a mono suspension for the rear seating and inverted suspension in the front. Next up, we have a LED headlight for this. Then LED indicators, and it comes with 3 modes, Eco, City and Sport. Now you may ask me, what are these 3 different modes? In 3 different modes, we get 3 different ranges. For the Eco mode, we get around almost 140 kilometers. And to City and Sport, it almost decreases because the speed increases and the performance of the vehicle increases with this. And the next cool feature about RV400 is, it has an AI integrated sound system. So this is the basic information about the RV400. You can see all of these specifications everywhere, like listed on the vehicle if you go to a showroom. But now, let's see the most important part, the pros and cons of this vehicle. So let's see the pros of this vehicle. The first one, it has a clear white projector LED lights in the front and LED indicators for front and the rear, which is very good. So the next point, the performance of this vehicle is absolutely good. It gives in eco mode 140 kilometers. So the third important point of this vehicle, it is integrated with regenerative braking system. So whenever we use a braking, so and whenever the wheel rotates freely, the same motor acts as an alternator and it generates the power back and charges the vehicle again. Now the fourth point, coming to the suspension of this vehicle, it's very good. In the city traffic and the city bumps and everything, it handles very smoothly. So the next pro is, the bike comes with a combi brake, which is very useful in a city traffic. So overall the bike performs very well and it is quite nimble to ride in the city. So now let's see the cons of the vehicle. When I say cons, it's an owner experience. The owner, it's a 6 months old vehicle, and let's see what all are the problems the owner faced in this. So the first point, this key. It is important because to start the vehicle and everything, but this comes with a low grade plastic. Once it falls down, once or twice, it's broken. It comes apart. To buy a new one, you have to go back to the showroom and we have to spend like almost 2 to 3K. It'll be a problem for everyone. The next point, when you see the charging socket, it is placed over here, okay? So when you try to remove it, see, there is very little gap for this to remove. So it comes out very, like, it is very hard to get in there and take it out. Next up, you can see the rubber over here. The rubber, we tried to keep it with this because we have to save it from water. The water shouldn't go. So they try to stitch it with a thread. So this quality should improve. So the third point is the seating position. The seating position looks good in the start, but once you ride for like almost like 5 to 10 kilometers, you'll start to feel the strain in your body. And also the seat cushioning is substantial. So you can see it is a very less cushioning over here. And when it comes to rear, it has only this much. When if you remove the plating, it's only this much. So it's hard. This should be improved. The third point, the battery pack. It is placed here. The Revolt claims that we can remove it, but it's almost over 15 kgs. So if you try to remove it and place it back, placing it back again, normal person without an expert, that will be a problem. Because the expert knows how to remove it properly and place it back because the wire will be over there. But if we try to remove it and play while placing it back, the wire may come in the middle. So we don't know if we cut a wire, then that will become a problem for this. So Revolt has this cool feature, which is AI sound system. But there are many problems with this. So this bike had to change 2 speakers for it because it had a problem in the initial. So Revolt claims that we can change the sound through the app, but the app hasn't been registered yet. So we can't change the sound. So whatever the vehicle comes with the initial sound, that has been continued till now. So there was important feedback from our owner that there was a glitch in the software. Like initially the battery was showing 80%. So he moved around almost like 15 kilometers, but still the battery should show, right? It suddenly showed 0%. Then he was in shock, like what happened? Then for a few minutes he waited, like he turned off the vehicle and he waited, but still it showed 0%. Then he turned it on, then he went for like 100-150 meters, then it showed back to the proper percentage again. So there was a small glitch. They have to work on the software update also. So when it comes to this vehicle, the fender of this is a bit side, okay? What happens because of this is, the left side of the rider, it completely becomes the dirt. Whenever they go through the water, all the water falls on them. So this has to be changed. So when we open this, you can see this part, okay? This part comes with a low-grade plastic. Next, to remove the battery pack, we need to insert the key over here. First, turn off the MCB and remove the plug over here like this. Pull it out, then remove the battery. While inserting it back, this wire comes in the middle. So we have to be careful while inserting it back, okay? Now, let's see the pickup in echo mode. So first mode, which is echo mode, okay? 3, 2, 1. It's very good. See, you can see, you can feel the power itself in the echo mode, right? I'm repeating it again, okay? Now I'll be doing it again over this side. Yeah, now you can see the pickup again. I'm going it again. 3, 2, 1. See, it goes smoothly. It gives an instant pickup. Even in echo mode, it gives an instant pickup. Now let's check out the city mode, which is the second mode of this vehicle. Now, let's go to the second mode by just toggling it on the second mode, which is the city mode. Now, see the pickup in city mode. 3, 2, 1. You can just feel instant pickup, like you can just feel the instant change of this. The speed, the feel, it changes everything. See, let's see over here. Now you can see again. Okay, 3, 2, 1. See, it just goes in a city mode. It flies in a city mode itself. Let's see how it goes in the sport mode. Now let's go with the third mode, which is the sport mode. To do that again, toggle it to third mode, sport mode. Let's see in 3, 2, 1. It just goes, guys. Like, I'm giving a full throttle, like legit full throttle. It's like flying completely. Now, sport mode in 3, 2, 1. Let's go. Sport mode is next level, guys. Like, it's literally flying. You can see the range is decreasing, but the feel and the performance, you can compare it with any sports bike, like legit. It's so good. So, the overall performance of this vehicle, absolutely, like top notch. No problem about that. When it comes to a middle class person, whoever buys this, he can enjoy it, like literally. Because we are saving fuel price, we are saving the tax, we can evade tax through this. I'll cover that in the next topic, upcoming videos. So, I'll see you guys in the next video. Thank you for watching.